Good morning. Myself Santosh Bharti. Now, in last lectures, I discussed about the multiplexing techniques used in the mobile radio environment. Multiplexing techniques basically frequency division multiplexing and time division multiplexing. Right? Now, today I will discuss about the design parameters at the base station and the mobile station. Okay? So how many parameters are required, what is the power level, what is the separation between two base stations, all these parameters, the requirement of all these parameters, today I will discuss. Clear? On first slide, come to the design parameter of the base station. The first part, when we design the base station, now first we find out the exact location. Location or antenna locations. Antenna locations means the base station antenna locations, right? For which now we can radiate the energy in the free space or in the environment. Clear? The next part is the antenna spacing and antenna height. What is the separation between two base station antenna? Clear? For which we can receive or we can transmit our signal without any distribution or without any disturbances. Other is the antenna height. What will be the antenna height for which we can increase the coverage of the coverage region? When we increase the coverage region, now ultimately, when we increase the antenna height, ultimately we can cover the large region. Clear? Now, third point is antenna orientation dependency. Antenna orientation means if you are using the, what is the orientation? If the mobile unit transmit the information to the base station, yeah, if the suppose there is the inclined angle between the mobile station and the base station, mobile unit and the base station, if alpha, suppose the inclined angle is defined by the parameter alpha, if alpha is 0 degree, alpha is 0 degree means there is the smallest correlation coefficient of the received signal by the two base station antenna. Clear? If alpha is increases, now the correlation coefficient of the received signal from the two base station antenna is decreases. So this is basically defined by the antenna orientation dependency. And next parameter is the antenna height and the separation dependency. Now in the similar way, what is the role of antenna height to cover the region? What is the role of antenna height to increase, to decrease the co-channel interference or interferences between the different cells? The separation dependency, what must be the separation between two base station antenna for which we can minimize the interferences? Interferences means either co-channel interference or adjacent channel interference. The next parameter is the frequency dependency. Frequency dependency, ideally we design the base station at the frequency of 850 MHz. Yeah, but we can also transmit or receive our signal other than 850 MHz frequency. So this is basically studied by the frequency dependency. Later I will discuss about one of these parameters. Then the antenna configuration. Which type of antenna configuration are used at the base station design? In general, the omnidirectional antenna or isotropic antenna are used for the base station antenna, for which it can equally radiate in all the direction. Right? So this is all the antenna configuration. Basically, because in the free space, the noise and interferences are more affected compared to the wired communication. Clear? Because in the free space, signal are diffracted or signal are reflected from the different object and received by the receiving antenna. So there are multiple copies of received signal. Electromagnetic signals are received at the receiving antenna. Then how to find the desired signal? How to select the desired signal at the receiving antenna? So this procedure, the multiple copies of the received signal, basically known as the faded signal. Clear? So how to minimize the fading of the received signal, multiple signal or multi-path signal, by using the antenna diversity techniques. So in especially base station antenna, antenna configuration are using the omnidirectional antenna, then the tilt antenna configuration means if the radiation pattern through the radiation pattern of the one base station antenna is affected the pattern of the other antenna, created the co-channel interferences or the adjacent channel interferences. This can be minimized or reduces by using the antenna tilting. Antenna tilting means when tilt the antenna at certain angle, now the one notch is created. Because of this notch, it reduces the magnitude of the radiation field. Now we can minimize the co-channel interferences. And other configuration are the diversity antenna configuration. Basically, the diversity technique, space diversity is used to minimize the fading of the received signal. Next is the noise parameters, noise environment. What type of the noise are affected of the base station antenna when you design the base station? So later I will discuss in detail. And last one, the power and feed strength conversion. How to convert the watt in the decibel or micro decibel, dBm, dBw. This can be studied in this topic. That is the power and feed strength conversion. Now I am going to discuss in detail to each and every parameters. So first parameter is the antenna location. So antenna location is the very important. It is very difficult to select the optimum antenna location for the base station. Clear? In mobile communication, that is the how to select the antenna configuration. Basically, suppose this is the hexagonal cell. These are the hexagonal cell. Yeah? At the midpoint, now we put the transmitter. But what about at this edge? At the here, that the signal, when the mobile unit is nearby the base station, now signal strength is good. But if the mobile unit are used at the boundary of the cell, what about the signal strength? The signal strength may be the minimum signal strength. For this configuration, now we use this kind of configuration. Means this is the base station. This base station covered now this region. This covered this region. But what about these regions? At these regions, now the signal strength may be the minimum. So now assume that this kind of configuration, now this region is overlapped with this region is again overlapped on this region, because if the user in this region, now ultimately he will be the great or good or excellent signal strength. So basically this is a very tough job to identify and to find the antenna location. Right? Then the first, the signal strength cover. Basically the antenna location is depend upon the, therefore the plan for the base station antenna location should be considered both coverage range and the interference with the other channel. When you design the base station, so to select the antenna location, base station antenna location for which it can cover the maximum region and it cannot interfere with the other cells locations or other cells area, right? So this basically under the antenna locations. So for example, if you consider the two kind of the tailing configuration, if you are putting your base station antenna in the flat environment. Now it covers the circular region. Circular region means like this region. But if you are putting base station in the hilly area, now it cannot cover the circular region, but it is covered like the starfish region, maybe like this. Maybe like this. If the, suppose this is the base station, if the user is here,
it may be receive the signal, but what about if the user is here? What about it cannot get the any signal from the base station? Then using the this kind of the configuration, using this kind of configuration means you can see from here, this is the top high spot point. If you are putting the high spot point, this point is known as the high spot. High spot means the high peak of the hill. If you are putting the base station here, at this point signal receives good, signal strength is good, but what about here? Signal strength is not good. Signal strength is not good because the effective height of the antenna is much much less than the actual height of the antenna. Now you can see from here, effective height of the antenna is less than, and far B, if considered now this, at here the strong signal, at here the weak signal. The effective height of the antenna is greater than the actual height of antenna. Clear? What can do to receive the signal at the everywhere, at this point also? Now put the this base station at the low spot point. At the lowest power point, right? The next configuration you can see. So this is the improper setup of the antenna location, antenna, base station antenna location, and this is the proper setup of the base station antenna location. Here we set up at here, the lowest power point, the base station. Now you can see this is the actual height of the antenna, and this is the effective height of the antenna. Here you will get the effective height of antenna is always greater than the actual height of antenna. For this situation, now you can receive the signal everywhere at the high spot point and at the low spot point, or in between the high spot point and low spot point. So this is the proper setup of the base station antenna. Clear? So there are the several steps in choosing the base station location. First, decide on a reception level at the cell boundary. This is based on the features of the mobile transceiver and the system performance required. Clear? Choose a location where land is usually available for the first choice. For the first choice of the base station means for the flat terrain. First choice means for the flat terrain, because in flat terrain, now the circular configuration, circular coverage region is covered by the base station antenna. Clear? The third one, follow the new path loss prediction model to make a point-to-point prediction. Point-to-point prediction is to find the point-to-point in the flat terrain. An equal strength contour can be drawn on the map based on the specified instruction. And choose other locations and draw the -100 dBm equal strength at the cell boundary. How to make the separation between the antenna? Basically, at the cell boundary, minimum received power must be the -100 dBm. If it is less than this value, the signal reception cannot be written. Fifth point, avoid the equal strength contour conditions shown in figure 6.1b from this figure. You can see from this figure, if you are considering like this configuration, you will not get the everywhere the, at this point you will not receive the signal, at this point you will not receive the signal, at this point you will not receive the signal. That's why choose the always not this type of configuration, right? Next point is the antenna spacing and the antenna height. Clear? Antenna spacing. In the real mobile radio environment, there are two effects that make mobile radio communications very difficult. First, the multi-path fading, and other one is the excessive path loss. Multi-path fading means at the receiving end, we receive the multiple copy of the RF signal. Multiple copy means it is very difficult to receive to identify the desired signal. Clear? Then this problem can be overcome by using the diversity technique. Diversity technique is basically minimize the fading of the signals. Fading of the signal identify the desired signal. Yeah, at the base station, the RST scheme can be used to reduce the fading, and the antenna height can be raised to increase the signal reception level. So there are many diversity schemes can be used to minimize the fading. Among them, the space diversity can be used, because space diversity use the frequency band almost equals to the transmission channel bandwidth. Yeah? Because the space diversity scheme does not use more frequency spectrum than just channel bandwidth. So these are the basically techniques to use the antenna spacing and the separation of the antenna. So this is the block diagram for which we can say, suppose this is the base station, this is the base station, and this represents the separation between two base station antenna, and this is the mobile unit. This is the mobile unit. If user make a call or transmit a signal to the base station, now in the broad case means if the angle between the mobile user and the base station is zero. This is the broad side case. At this situation, now the correlation rule, define the correlation coefficient between two base station antenna. Clear? Basically, this represents the received power. The power variations of the power, received power variation between the two base station antenna. Clear? Alpha equals to 0, the minimum correlation coefficient between the two base station. If alpha is 90 degree, here this is the maximum correlation coefficient is maximum between the two base station antenna. Clear? So this depend upon the separation between the antenna. What must be the separation between two base station antenna for which we can minimize the co-channel interference between two cells. Adjacent channel interference between two clusters. Clear? So this separation is very very important parameter. So where the efficiency is defined by H upon T. D is the separation between the two base station antenna. H is the height of the actual antenna. Height of the actual base station antenna. Clear? So basically, if alpha is 0 degree, rho is minimum. Rho is minimum means this is approximately 0.4. If alpha is 90 degree, now rho is maximum. It is approximately 0.7. At rho equals to 0.7, now efficiency is almost 100%. That is the 1. If efficiency is 1, means D, H equals to D. H equals to D means separation between two base station antenna is equals to the actual height of the antenna. Practically, this is the impossible case. Now, this drawback is minimized by using the diversity antenna techniques, diversity antenna configuration, where we provide the sufficient separation between two base station antenna, for which we can minimize. We can avoid or we can use the different configuration diversity. 3 means triangular diversity is antenna techniques, or we can minimize the two antenna configuration of the techniques. Right? So next parameter is basically antenna orientation and antenna dependency. In antenna orientation, basically there are two cases are applied. Alpha equals to 0. Alpha equals to 0 means this is the broad side case. And alpha equals to 90 degree, this is the inclined case. In broad side case, now there is the minimum correlation coefficient between two base station antenna. Why? In inclined case, there are the maximum correlation coefficient between two antenna cases. So now you can see here the wave transmitted from the mobile unit mile away at an angle alpha as shown in the figure 6.3. This is the figure 6.3. Are received by two base station antenna who propagate through a different scatters in the media. The difference in correlation coefficient of two fading signal depend upon the separation of two antennas and the direction of the angle. The intuitive logic reason as the lower value of correlation coefficient would be obtained from the broadside kit. At alpha equals to 0, now correlation coefficient is minimum. At alpha equals to 90 degree, now correlation coefficient is the maximum. This is because of two received signal. Fading signal will be tend to be the same in the inclined case. The fading signal received at the base station antenna and the inclined case come up at the first antenna from the same separation path. Clear? So already I told the parameter neta equals to this quantity. If we plot at the 0 degree, at alpha equals to 0 degree, now you can see this is this graph. At alpha equals to 45 degree, this. Alpha equals to 60 degree, this. Now this curve is alpha equals to 0 degree and alpha equals to 60 degree. This curve is very very close to the alpha equals to 0 degree. But we are putting the alpha equals to 90 degree. Now correlation coefficient varies from 0.7 to 1. But if you are substituting alpha equals to 60 degree, now correlation coefficient is varying from 0.4 to 1 and 45.3 to 0.9, 30 again 0.3 to 0.9. So this is the comparison of the correlation coefficient and the efficiency of the received signal with respect to the inclined angle alpha. Right? Now you can see more clear. You can see more clear at this point. So this is the, there are the two base station antenna. D is the separation between these two antenna and this is the inclined angle. Direction of the transmission. Inclined angle or direction of the transmission. If alpha is 0, correlation, difference between the correlation coefficient two base station is minimum. When alpha is increases, now the difference in the correlation coefficient between two base station antenna is also increases. Clear? So these are the, now you can see from gravity, the rule is varying from 0.7 to 1. Great improvement in the performance is the shown in figure. Clear? So rho equals to 0.7 to 1. Now there is the great increment of the performance of the figure. From 0 to 0.7, 0 to 0.7 is the relatively slight improvement in the performance. So rho equals to 0.7 is chosen for the cost effectiveness in realizing the physical antenna spacing. Now I am considering the two cases. For the broadside case means alpha equals to 0 degree. The example given, if rho is, because the optimum value of the rho is 0.7 for designing purpose. For rho is 0.7, then at this value we will get the neta is 11. Neta is 11. For point rho is, neta is 2 for the broadside case. With the given antenna height of the 30 meter, but the different value of the neta, the antenna spacing can be determined by this formula. This value antenna is 11. Now separation is, how much separation is needed? 9 feet separation is needed for the value of this rho. If you are putting the 0.125, the 50 feet or 15 feet meter are required antenna separation. Clear? I mean lowering the value of neta lowers the value of, lowering the value of neta lowers the value of neta, widens the antenna spacing D. Widens the spacing D, right? Are increasing the antenna height, now the higher the antenna height, widens the antenna spacing D. For an actual antenna height, means that is 100 feet or 30 meter, the separation required between two receiving antenna for the broadside case is either 3 meter based on the data equals to 11, and it is the 15 meter if the data equals to 2. Then basically, if the antenna performance, the correlation coefficient is decreases, now the diversity performance are increases. It is found that the smaller the correlation coefficient, better will be the diversity performance. Clear? So this case for the, if the effective antenna height is low, by 15 meter or 15 feet, and the separation is kept same, 3 meter or 9 feet, then the efficiency, antenna efficiency is 5.5, which is equivalent to the correlation coefficient rho. Right? And the matter of fact, when the effective antenna height is lower, the signal reception level is decreases. Clear? So antenna height gain, how to calculate the antenna height gain? This is equals to 20 log base 10 effective height divided by the actual height. Clear? Effective height is how much? 50 feet. While the actual height is 50. So the power loss is, antenna height gain is how much? Minus 6 dB. This is in loss. This is in loss. Right? The advantage of choosing this, in this case the signal drops 6 dB, but the diversity advantage increases. Diversity performance increases as rho decreases from 0.7 to 0.4. Clear? Basically this is not a peak, this is a rho. Rho decreases from 0.7 to 0.4. On the other hand, if the effective antenna height is increased 60 meter or 200 feet, then the antenna height gain result again 20 log. This, when substituting value, this is plus 6 dB. Now it is gain. Here the value of theta become 22. The correlation coefficient is basically the 0.9 for theta is 22, obtained from figure, which diminishes the diversity improvements. Mean diversity performance is decreases. Therefore, when antenna height is increases, now the antenna height gain also increases. But when rho is increased, correlation coefficient is increases, now diversity advantage is decreases. Clear? There are second case. When we consider the inclined case, that is alpha equals to 90 degree, I already told at this value, now rho is 0.7 and rho is the value of theta is 1 or the correlation coefficient, that is 0.7. At this value, when you substitute, now the antenna height must be equal to the separation between two antenna height. This means that the required separation of two receiving antenna is the same as the antenna height. Right? If the antenna height is 30 meter or 100 feet, then the separation also 100 feet is required. In reality, the separation of 100 feet between 200 feet receiving antenna is impossible practically. Right? So this drawback can be overcome by using the diversity antenna configuration. Now next, come to the frequency dependency. Basically, these parameters, you can see this graph is plotted at the frequency of 850 MHz. At here you can see the frequency of 850 MHz. But if you are using plotting the graph between the efficiency and the correlation coefficient as a function of the direction of transmission at the other frequency other than the 850 MHz, you will find the antenna separation is modified. This is equal to D 850 M upon F dash, where F is the 850 MHz and F is the given frequency. This formula is valid only for the frequency greater than 30 MHz. Yeah? In designing and calculating antenna spacing for space diversity in a mobile radio environment, the same experimental curve used for the frequency of 850 megahertz, right? Can be used to compute the antenna separation for other frequency, where f dash is the frequency megahertz. For example, if we assume that f dash is 85 megahertz, the required antenna separation is 10 times larger than the required antenna separation at the 850 megahertz. If these 3 meter are 9 feet, d dash is the 30 meter are, I mean 10 times means 30 meters, which is obviously impractical. Therefore, the space diversity is not recommended at the lower frequency, especially at the base station, because the physical separation between two antenna has become impractically large. So this is the frequency independency. Now come to the antenna configuration. When we design the base station, so there are very important to design the antenna configuration. At the base station, basically use the directional antenna. Use the directional antenna or use the isotropic antenna, which are equally radiated in all the direction. Right? So transmitting and receiving antenna will be physically separated to provide additional isolation, though the transmitted band and the received band are widely apart. So this section will concentrate on the basically directional antenna and the tilting antenna configuration and the diversity antenna configuration. Basically, the directional antenna, suppose this is the antenna. Now it equally radiates in all the direction. Clear? Isotropically radiate the direction. If we draw the radiation pattern, suppose this center point is some direction, with the electromagnetic energy is maximum, in some direction may be the minimum. So this is the main lobe and this is the side lobe. Clear? Because of this main lobe, maybe other cells are also affected, means co-channel interferences are increased. Then how to minimize now this radiation pattern by tilting the antenna configuration? By tilting the configuration means by tilting the directional antenna. When we provide some tilt angle, now this antenna configuration is like this. If tilting angle is increases, now notch is also increases. At the zero like this. Increases like this. So this notch is reduced by increasing the tilting of the antenna configuration. Now third one is the diversity antenna configuration. So this is basically used to minimize if alpha is 90 degree. Now the antenna separation requires the actual antenna height. So this is practically impossible. So this drawback can be minimized by using the diversity antenna configuration. Now you can see here individually directional antenna I also told. So besides depending on the frequency band isolation and the physical space ratio, in general we can say directional antenna are used to equally radiate the power or electromagnetic energy in all the direction. Clear? Because of directional antenna, flow of electromagnetic energy in all the direction, maybe some mobile cells are affected. If mobile cells are affected, means their frequency of operation is affected. Their frequency of operation is affected means co-channel interference are increased. Clear? So this is the drawback of the isotropic antenna. So how to minimize this drawback? By using the tilting of the directional antenna. By providing some tilt angle of the directional antenna. Now it can minimize the radiation pattern. Maximum means energy of electromagnetic energy in the desired direction is the minimized by providing notch of the this filter. So this point is known as basically the notch. This notch is depend upon the tilting angle. If tilting angle is increases, now this notch is also increases. Clear? If minimize the tilt angle, now the notch is also minimized. Clear? So this is basically, now you can see here, this is the tilt of the antenna configuration. Yeah, you can see the nodes. Basically, this is the one node, other node, this node, this node, I mean this node. If you are increasing the tilt angle, now the node is increases. Clear? So by this way now we can minimize the co-channel interference. So this is the node become larger when the tilt angle increases. The node can be used to effectively reduce the interference in the co-channel channel. Right? The average signal to interference ratio and interfered cell region interfered by the serving cell antenna side is improved by tilting the clear. That is the when tilt angle is increases, tilt angle is increases, I mean the notch is increases. The notch is increases. If notch is increases, I mean signal to interference ratio is also increases. Clear? The limited loss of the antenna gain is accepted in some part of the serving cell to achieve or increase on the average signal to interference ratio in the interfered cell area. Then the diversity antenna configuration, I have already told that diversity antenna configuration, it minimizes for the design purpose. We assume that alpha equals to 0, direction of transmission, that is alpha equals to 0 for the broad side cases. But in cases when the direction of transmission is changed from 0 to 90 degree, at the 90 degree it will require the separation between two base station antenna is equal to the actual antenna height. Actual antenna height means 100 feet. This is practically impossible. So this drawback is minimized by using the diversity antenna cases. In diversity antenna cases, basically at alpha equals to 0, the degree of diversity advantage is much less than for the alpha equals to 90 degree, because the separation requirement for alpha equals to 0 is much less than at the alpha equals to 90 degree. For example, suppose d at alpha equals to 0 degree is much less than d at alpha equals to 0 degree is much smaller than d at alpha equals to 90 degree. Clear? If decreases, separation decreases, now the diversity performance is increases. Clear? Here at 0 equals to, now D is minimum. D decreases, now diversity performance is decreases. Clear? At this point alpha equals to 0, D is minimum means diversity performance is also minimum. At the alpha equals to 90 degree, D is maximum. Separation maximum means the diversity performance is also maximum. At this situation, if you are using correlation coefficient is 0.7, at this situation it will require the antenna separation is actually equal to the actual antenna height. This is practically impossible. To overcome this situation, now using the antenna diversity techniques by using the triangular configuration of three omnidirectional antenna means you can see here the separation between 60 and now this is the 90 degree, now this again 60 degree. Clear? What about this angle? This is the 30 degree. So at alpha equals to 90 degree, only two antenna is working. Antenna 1 and antenna 2 is working. Antenna 1 and antenna 2 is working. At alpha equals to 30 degree, antenna 2 and antenna 3 is only working. Similarly, at alpha equals to 45 degree, only antenna 1 and antenna 3 is working. So by this cases, only two antenna is working. So at this situation, now alpha equals to 90 degree cases will never happen. Alpha equals to 90 degree this will never happen means it will never require the separation of two base station antenna is equal to the actual antenna height. So this can be done by using this configuration. The next point is the noise environment when you design the base station. Noise environment means in human made noise at the base station provide the noise level for the signal to noise ratio at the base station, etc. So two kind of the spurious noise are affected when you design the base station. One is the automotive noise and other is the industrial plant noise. In mobile radio environment, the dominant noise is automotive noise. What is the automotive noise? First of all, the secondary noise source is power generating facilities, and the third rank noise source is the industrial equipment. Industrial equipment means when you meet the when you join the two materials, two connecting materials by the welding machines. Basically, it generates a spark. It generates a spark means it generates the impulsive energy. Suddenly increase the energy. Now this impulsive energy contains the infinite amount of energy. Now this impulsive energy now affect the communication system. Other noise such as from the consumer product, lighting system, medical equipment, electrical trains and brushes are low noise and can be ignored. Right? These are the noises affect. What is the automotive noise? The primary sources of automotive radio noises are the ignition system. Ignition system is basically the for the arc welding. Arc welding now it generate the spikes. Spikes means suddenly increase the magnitude of the energy level. Now it increases the infinite amount of energy. For example, when thundering is done, thundering is done means it gives the infinite amount of energy. That's why sometimes the green tree is the fall out, some electrical equipment is burned out, some electronics equipment is burned out because it contains the infinite amount of the energy. Other with the radiation produced by the high pulse current and voltage in the cabling. And the third point is the point of ignition circuit discontinuity. So these are the causes of automotive noises which affect the base station system. At the base station system, in the figure 13, now you can see this is the base station. Now this is the base station. This is the base station antenna. And there are n equals to 6 means there are 6 interfering signals where m is the mobile unit or number of the. In the figure at the base station, the antenna is usually 36 meter or 123 or more from the mobile ignition noise sources, which makes the noise level received by the base station receiver lower than that of the street level as received by the mobile unit receiver. Basically, these are the noise sources. There are n equals to 6. N equals to 6 means there are the six noise sources. Clear? The ignition noise driven from the ignition system of the mobile unit itself and from other mobile unit. Assume that the ignition noise level at the mobile unit is based on the number of m. Ignition system, m is number of m ignition system. Basically, these are the ignition system. These are the ignition systems. How many ignition systems? M ignition systems. Assume that the ignition noise level at the base station, at the mobile unit is the number of m of ignition system and the average distance given from the surrounding mobile unit. And assume that the ignition noise level at the base station is based on 2. L and D2. So, for example, at the mobile unit, it is depend upon the. Now you can see here, ignition noise system, noise level. Ignition noise level at mobile unit is depend upon the function of either m and distance given, while ignition noise level at the base station is the function of n at the distance d2. By the d1 and d2, in next figure you can see this is the distance d1. This is the ignition, noise ignition system. This is the ignition system at the center, not the mobile unit, user. So this distance is d1. And from here to here, from here to here, this distance is d2. And from here to here, from center to here, this distance is d1. And from here, from base station to here, that is the distance is d2. Clear? Distance is d2. Basically, at the mobile unit is depend the number of the ignition system. And how many ignition system? N equals to 6, that is the base station. Clear? Since the base station antenna height is 33 meter or 30 meter or 100 feet or more, it receives the ignition noise level from the large number of mobile ignition system because of its height. Clear? The number of N is larger than the number of M. Say, what is the relation? Means N is always greater than capital N is always greater than capital M. Maybe practically used is N is approximately equal to 10 times of M. For this situation, however, the distance D2 is also greater than the D1. And this D2 is also greater than D1. The difference is noise level. Now you can see from this formula, difference is noise level. Difference is noise level from this figure. Delta L is the difference is noise level. This is 10 log 10 n phi and d1 upon d2 whole square. Where 10 log 10, the relation is n is 10 times m. So 10 into 30 feet divided by 120 feet, that is the minus 2 dB. Once the average ignition noise level at a mobile unit receiver in a particular area is known, the base station receiver noise level is about 1 to 2 dB lower because its antenna is located away from the ignition noise. Clear? Ignition noise. So this is the formula to calculate the ignition noise level difference. The power line noise and the industrial noise. Because of the power line noise, because of the industrial noise, the radio noise arises within the spectral range from the fundamental generation of the frequency. Fundamental generation of the frequency, either 50 Hz or 60 Hz into the ultra high frequency range. The power line noise dominates the low frequency as shown in figure. Clear? The electric field strength in dB relative to 1 microvolt per meter per megahertz is shown in the y-axis. The industrial noise level is found as follows. Suppose that the frequency 100 megahertz and the high level noise of the power line is 340 kilovolt. At 65 meter is approximately 200 feet away from the 90 dB. Changing this to a power scale with a 50 ohm resistance providing the vector is expressed. Okay? The power and field strength conversion. Now this topic we will consider in the next lecture. I will consider this in the next lecture. Thank you.